of stuff.
Yeah.
Okay? So you have to make sure everything is written down properly, okay? Now he's also talking about a third party that is looking or likely to be involved in this as well. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
Okay? Okay. Right. I asked if it's good or bad. He said, this is where you'll need to be careful. Okay? Right, this is your business, he's telling me.
Yes.
Okay? So you need to be the majority holder of this. This is what he wants you to know. Okay? Right, because somebody just said somebody's been trying to persuade you to give a little bit more away. Does that make sense? Or to expand something around it?
Nothing like that, do not.
He's also talking about a little girl around you as well.
I'm sorry?
A little girl around you?
Yeah.
Okay, so you have a daughter?
I'm not married.
Okay, but he's talking about a little girl around you. Would you understand that a 6 or 7 year old little girl may have passed the spirit around you or within the family?
I don't remember.
Okay. It may not be with you, but sometimes it's information that you might need to actually find out and ask from family. Okay? Right. But I think this is something going quite far back within the family as well. Don't worry about it now, okay? It may come to you later on, okay, over the next week or so, okay? Just a bit more. Right. What you did. Okay. He's also talking about like a stick or a walking stick. So I'm not sure if he used to use a walking stick or there's somebody around you that uses a walking stick. Oh, no, hang on a second. He's talking about support, that you're having to give support to somebody as well. Do you understand this?
Yeah.
Okay. But he just said to me, not much longer, so it's either they're going to start supporting themselves, okay? But he wants you to also know the struggle is nearly finished. The struggle is nearly finished, that's what he just said to me.
Okay.
Okay, you understand that? Okay. But he also... Right. For some reason he wants to give some love and blessings to your mum as well.
I'm sorry?
Love and blessings to your mum as well. Do you understand why he was there? Obviously, it'd be nice for you. Do you understand that? Okay?
Because she's not well.
Sorry?
She's not well.
She's not well. Okay. So I'll get my doctor to go over to see your mum as well, okay? Okay. I'm going to leave it there for you, okay? But this is how it works. Okay? A lovely, really lovely gentleman spirit. Okay? And... Right, thank you. He just said to me, actually, I'm really missed, and I really missed them too. Okay? So this was a person that was really involved in everybody's lives. You understand that? Okay. I'm going to leave it there for you. Okay? Any questions? So this is what we do. Okay? So I think the spirit will give a bit of evidence about the person. Okay? His evidence was that he passed with a chest infection. Okay?
Do you see them?
Do I see them?
Yeah.
I see them about 98% of the time.
98%
of the time. Okay. If I don't see them, they'll give me an image in my mind, in my third eye. Okay. The majority, I can hear them. I'll always be able to hear them, apart from one time. I was doing a show, and I just pulled up outside the show. It's for charity. And they said to me, Nick, we're going to be working differently with you tonight. I was like, this is a really important charity event. You know, you can't change the way you're working with me tonight. Yes, you can. So I'm on the stage, 300 people in front of me. I said, okay, spirit, I need to work. I need to get somebody. Where am I going? And I was looking for somebody. They weren't there. I heard a voice, a very, very faint voice. And it was like somebody standing in the very, very back of the room. And I had to concentrate on that voice. And that's because they wanted me to concentrate more.
That's so, they choose you for as a medium. Can you choose them?
No, I don't choose them. They choose me. They choose you. Okay, it's like guides.
It's a random.
Sorry?
It's a random process.
It's a random process.
It's a space random process.
Random.
Randomly pick.
They will, yes, it is kind of random. But they will come and test your energy, see if their energy is actually on the same vibration as yours, or your vibration is on the same as them. Okay? And what I always believe as well, from what I understand, is that when my spirituality starts to grow, as it has been, okay, we'll always have one guide that will be with us from life to death. Okay? But we'll have many guides in between. And the greater your spirituality grows, the higher these guides become. But there will always be the ones that work with you as well. So Dr. John is a leader, he'll always work with me. And I got told something very strange by somebody in the UK, that another medium said to somebody else that they've taken their guide away from them and given them a different guide. You don't do that. You can't do that. It's not in our right to do that. But they want to say, actually, I don't want to work with you anymore. It's in our life together as a guide and medium, then that's, I have to live with that. That's their choice. Yeah? Any more questions?
Are you saying spirits and ghosts?
Spirits and ghosts?
Yeah, right. How do these?
Ghosts are memories.
Ghosts are memories?
Yeah. So ghosts are like memories. Of, you know, when you go to an old place, and you know, I was in Delhi the other day. I could see an old man sitting in the corner. And when I leaned to the old man while I was trying to make my dinner, he said, "I'm always here, smoking a cigarette. I'm always here. This is my favourite place." But he was a ghost. And it was about the building. You know, when I looked around, it's I can't remember the name of the place. Some sort of peep shop. But when I looked around, the area changed. I could see lots of very elegant ladies sitting with rather large hats. I knew there was a lot of English sitting in this particular place. So I think it was going back some time. So, but ghosts are different to spirit. Any questions?
In our tradition, when we burn our loved ones,
yes.
We keep the ashes with us. And after we pour them in the holy water, it's a good thing to come. When the ashes are with us, they are with us, and after we pour them, they go to the heaven. What's the step? What's the surrounding? What does actually happen when they, does anything happen in the surrounding change?
No. I've got to be very careful because there's lots of belief systems. And somebody said to me, am I Hindu? I said, no, I'm not. I believe in all religions. Okay? This is the religion or belief that you have, okay? Which I think you, and I respect. Okay? My belief and understanding is that when we pass, when my spirit leaves my body, it's just a physical lump that's left. Okay? So if I'm cremated and sprinkled on the holy water, that's just my physical being given back to the earth. Okay? But my spirit is somewhere else or around you. Yeah. Everybody has their own belief. When I first met Chinmoy in Cardiff, after the show, I don't know if you remember, after the show, a young girl came up to me and she said, "So you believe God's a man?" I said, "If you believe what you'd like to believe, if you believe God is a man." I said, "I believe God is an everlasting, unconditional source of love that we will have." So, but we all have the belief, all different beliefs. I was doing an expedition in Norway. Another young lady came to me, about 24 years old, and said, "This is the lady that asked me if I was Hindu." I said, "No, I'm one with all religions." And she said, "Well, I'm Christian, and God is my creator, and Jesus Christ is my saviour." I said, "That's fantastic, very nice." I said, "But you need to learn a lesson." She said, "What's that?" I said, "You need to learn and respect all other religions." She said, "I can't do that." I said, "Why can't you do that?" She said, "Because my God will be jealous of me." I said, "If he was a God, he'd be jealous of me. He's no God at all. Yeah? No God would be jealous of somebody else to love and respect somebody else's religion or faith. This is what my job is. So I love all of you. I love every religion. I think all are right." Yeah? Go for Dr. John. Ooh. Dr. John. Okay. Well, Dr. John is the healing part.
That's not John, no.
You want two horns?
Two horns.
Okay, two horns.
Just talk about two horns and then.
Okay.
Because we ran out of time for 2 hours.
Okay. Yeah. We all say, "Oh, it's only 2 hours," and we all want to know it's Indian time, remember? Very nice. Voice and then they go out. That's exactly what I do. Okay. I do it in a more controlled way. Okay. So you will see a change in my appearance. My face will change slightly. My voice will change.
Can you ask?
Sorry?
Can you ask?
Can you ask me anything? Can you ask him? Yes, okay.
Right. What can you ask question? What about past or future? Can you answer what about future? What happened to the engineer?
You can ask him, I would say this, ask him anyone you like, okay? Just make sure you really want to know the answer, okay? If it's about the loved ones, he may not know about the loved ones, okay? Just a free warning, okay? He's a very philosophical man, and he likes to talk about Mother Earth, nature, and human life, etc. But if he knows the answer, he'll give it to you, okay? Yes, you can, but I would keep your questions out, like maybe one or two questions, because I did this for one demonstration work. Okay, I'm going to do a demonstration with two books for 20 minutes. Okay, 20 minutes. So I came back from letting two all come forward, and I went, wow, that was a really quick 20 minutes. And my wife said, no, Nick, it was 2 hours 20 minutes to do a chance. Okay, so how time flies when we're having fun. Okay, but keep it. Oh, I'll just keep going. To keep this going, okay? I have to take off certain things, okay?
On the inside, it's in the mobile tribute offices. Okay.
If you can't see the back, you may need to stand for this very short period.
I want to raise that chair on that.
I won't have my eyes open for this, okay? And the reason for that is because of the energy. I need to keep the energy going for him and for me also, okay? So I've got another half of it.
Nick have many years of experience with each other.
learning to blend our energy together for allowing me to come forward to give guidance. Some worthy work in your life or the life of you or others. Do we have questions?
Which year are you born?
Which year is that?
MH370.
Why you have the right to disbelieve. they are around you. Of course they are around you, they're your loved ones. But it's only in your mind that you question those things that go all around you, whether or not they come to you at night time or they hold your hand when you cry at night, yes? Yes, that. So you will have to believe that they are around you, don't you? Sometimes sooner than later. Yes?
I want to ask a question. My
yes.
father passed away 2 years ago. So I just wanted to know how is he, like, is he looking on us from above?
Can I answer this for everybody? Our loved ones, your loved ones, including my loved ones, we look upon those.